Three vulnerabilities were found in Netgear routers, ransomware hits businesses worldwide, and Print Nightmare leads to remote code execution attacks. All that coming up now on ThreatWire. Greetings, I am Shannon Morris, and this is ThreatWire for July 6, 2021. This is your weekly summary of the threats to our security, privacy, and internet freedom. FYI to my Hack 5 fans out there, the team just released a brand new Bash Bunny on the Hack 5 shop, and my patrons automatically get a discount as a perk. So check it out, support the brand, so that we can keep on making free content just like this. We have a whole bunch of new vulnerabilities to get into this week, so on to the news. Attackers could bypass authentication and take over Netgear routers, as well as access stored credentials, using three different bugs discovered by Microsoft security researchers. These vulnerabilities were found in the Netgear DGN 2200 V1 series of routers while the researchers were doing work on device fingerprinting, at which time they noticed odd behavior where a non-IT personnel was trying to access the router's management port. That's strange. The details of the vulnerabilities are included in the Microsoft 365 Defender team blog. Now, Netgear did patch these three bugs way back in December, which are tracked as PSV2020-0363, 0364, and 0365, and they range from a 7.4 to a 9.4 in severity. When the researchers noticed the activity, they downloaded the router firmware and they analyzed the HTTPD binary since the odd traffic was happening on that specific port. They found that they could successfully achieve a complete and fully reliable authentication bypass. They also found they could grab the router credentials using a side channel attack, and then they tried to grab the credentials using the backup and restore features, and they found that that worked too. They could allow an attacker to gain access to any page on a router management GUI, including ones that required authentication, by appending get variables. The HTTP headers had an issue in how they verify users, which leads to the side channel attacks. And the third issue had to do with the researchers using the first flaw to extract the router configuration restore file. It was encrypted, yes, using a constant key, which was spelled NTGR, like Netgear, BAK. And that allowed for extracting stored credentials. Even though these were patched back in December, I am well aware that many home users, for example, never update their routers. So add that to your summer cleaning checklist, check your router for updates, and just do a quick patch. It won't take any time at all. The enterprise IT firm Kaseya confirmed that they were hit with ransomware attacking their VSA product, which is used for remotely monitoring point-of-sale systems, networks, PCs, and connected devices. Now, this happened during the holiday weekend, unfortunately. Kaseya believes that this only affected their on-premises customers only due to their fast response, but later, other customers like managed service providers revealed that they were affected as well. Now, this issue actually impacts well over 1,000 businesses, according to some reports, but the exact total is currently unknown. We have seen several different totals, so we don't know the exact amount that are actually impacted. However, Kaseya supports over 40,000 businesses worldwide. So businesses affected included a supermarket chain from Sweden, but no other businesses have come forward saying that they were affected at time of recording, but we will be updating on social media if you follow me there. So the Revil ransomware gang announced that they were behind this attack and they demanded a payment of $70 million in Bitcoin before they would publicly publish a decryptor key for all of the victims. So chances are it's not just one victim. None of the victims reported that data was stolen. It appears this attack happened and was successful due to a zero-day vulnerability in the Kaseya VSA. Specifically, that's an authentication bypass vulnerability in the web interface. Kaseya took their on-premises servers totally offline as soon as they realized the attack was occurring. Now, CISA and the FBI issued a joint advisory recommending customers using VSA download the VSA detection tool, which can also detect Revil components. They also recommend using MFA or multi-factor authentication on all of your accounts, and an investigation into this is currently ongoing, so we don't have all of the details quite yet. Big shout out to my Hush Puppy Perk Level patrons for sharing their fur baby photos and for the support. And a quick shout out to Neil, Ruben, Morx, and Mario for joining the Threatwire Alliance, and as always for supporting the show. Check out the Patreon Alliance for information on the new Hack 5 shop coupon code and your exclusive access to an audio-only podcast version of this show every single week. And now on to the third news story. Last Tuesday, a proof-of-concept exploit was dropped on GitHub, which turns out was a critical Windows security vulnerability in the Windows print spooler. It was removed from GitHub just hours later, but that was plenty of time for it to get copied and circulated. It's now being called Print Nightmare, and it was originally an elevation of privilege problem that was addressed, or so we thought, in June's Patch Tuesday. But it was later found to also lead to a remote code execution attack, and that patch did not fix this RCE flaw. Now, some security experts are saying that these two exploits are totally different, but Microsoft at first was notating this new RCE flaw as a part of the original issue that they already patched. But according to one of the original researchers, one that found that flaw that was already patched, that patch is incomplete, and it was meant to fix this RCE problem, but it did not include it. Now, the vulnerability is tracked as CVE-2021-1675, in case you want to look it up. But after the RCE vulnerability was introduced, again called Print Nightmare, Microsoft assigned a new CVE. So this one is CVE-2021-34527, separating it out from the original issue that was already patched because it uses a different attack vector, and it affects Windows 7 up to Windows 10, along with Server 2008 up to Server 2019, so 40 different system types in total. Confusing as all of that was, it's still a serious problem that should be known about. Security firm Sang4 posted a whole technical analysis of this issue on GitHub, along with a proof of concept code. It got cloned and shared by security researchers, some of whom shared their own proof of concepts. So since this is likely to be exploited, security experts are recommending that consumers and businesses should disable the spooler service within their environment, although most clients will be safe because of the default Windows firewall rules, just to be on the safe side. I do mention spooler service because the victim has to be targeted for it to work, and that victim has to be authenticated to the spooler service. The attacker has to authenticate as a domain user. A low-level user could exploit it, so phishing could come into play in order for an attacker to achieve success. That spooler service is usually enabled just automatically, so if targeted, it could be easy enough to exploit. So for now, it appears the best option is to disable the service on the domain controller or disable inbound remote printing through the group policy. So that means that you would not be able to print remotely. You would have to plug directly into a printer to print to it, but at least it would protect from inbound attacks. Zero Patch has also released micro patches that are unofficial, but they should block any attackers from being able to exploit it on vulnerable networks. So this week on Morse Code, I am continuing this new studio build. I'm actually currently in the new studio, so you can check out the final construction phase and see the build plan. This episode is being recorded in this new studio space, so growing pains. I know that there's an echo. Bear with me as it's not completely set up yet. It's still going through a few just finishing phases, so there's things for me to finish up, so don't judge me too harshly in the comments. Subscribe to my channel if you want to watch the entire build out and see how this is coming together. That's youtube.com/ShannonMorse for more. I will be out for 2 weeks visiting my family, so I will be back soon with Threatwire. With that, do not forget to like and subscribe to this channel as well. I'm Shannon Morse, and I will see you on the internet.